Hello everyone and welcome in a new video. In this video number 7, I'd like to show you how to use and how to configure some inputs in 5-bit. And we just discover the container and TCP input. 5-bit has many input. We can discover the list. We have container, we have HTTP JSON, Kafka, log, of course. We have already seen it, Redis, stdin, syslog, and UDP. So in our example, what we do, I have reinstalled our 5-bit on Elastic2. This is the terminal above, and in the below we have the ELK stack. So first of all, I just want to install Docker like it, and after it, what we do, we just add a new input in our 5-bit configuration. So we install Docker with docker-ce version. Yes. Okay. And now we just edit sudo vim slash etc 5-bit 5-bit.yml, and I go in the input block here. For example, I paste some line, so I define a type to container, I set enable to true, I define the path of our container logs, and for Docker this is in slash var lib docker and containers directory, and in containers directory we have one directory per container. So in each directory we have .log, some file with .log to store our logs. So we just need to configure our Elasticsearch target. So where it is here. I change the local host. I need to add the IPA to add this IP here. So I save it. I can use sudo systemctl restart of our 5-bit service. Okay, and now to test Docker, we can use a docker run dash dash rm and dash dash name c1. I just want to expose our 8080 for our Nginx container. I run it. And we can open our Kibana, and in Kibana I go into management, stack management, index management. I check we haven't any index. Okay, so now we can just curl our Elastic2 server on this IP and .42, I think, yes, and our port. Yes, we have a new line, and this line is in our slash var lib docker containers etc star dot log. So I can go now in our Kibana, and we have now we have many. Yes, this is because we have start. We have 9 line, I think, in our start process. So I can remove it. It's better. Delete index. I can send a new curl for our example. I can reload indices. I think yes, it's good. We have one document. We can create a new index pattern. 5-bit star. I can add the timestamp. And if I go now in our discover in analytics service, we can see we have one document, and in this document we have some logs about the Elastic2 server. We can find the container name, the image name for our container, and we have the name of our container, C1, and we can find that, I think, message. Yes, the message is the log line. Here we can find it. So this is our first example. Our second example, we want to use a TCP input. So to do it, I stop my container. I go into sudo vim slash etc slash 5-bit 5-bit.yml, and I can remove a container input. Sorry, I can remove container line, and I add the TCP type. And with the TCP type, I can define the max size of each message, and I want to listen on all ports. I think it's possible on all interfaces. Like it. Yes. Maybe yes. We can run it. I can restart 5-bit. Okay. I can check if we listen on port 9000. So sudo netstat dash ntop. Yes, we listen on port 9000. And to test it, we can use netcat, and we can connect on this port in our target server on .42 and port 9000. And if I want to send some data on this TCP socket, I can use echo, and I want to send some field 1, field 2, and field 3, for example. So I send it. You can stop, I think it's okay. And now I can go in our, I can drop before, it's better. I can drop our index here. I remove it. I remove index pattern. Yes, and I want so remove. Yes. I can send again our field, and I can check we have one document. Right, and if I create a new index pattern. Here, I just 5-bit. So I want to use, oh sorry, I want to use timestamp. I create the index pattern. I can go into our analytics service in discover, and now we have one line. If I check, we can go in this format. If I go here, we can find some line about 5-bit on our Elastic2 server. And if we go in the message, we have our three fields. We can zoom. Field 1, field 2, field 3. And if I add a new line, for example, hello XavKey, I can set it again. And if I refresh, I have another document. We have two documents. So we can go at the bottom here. Yes. Ah, this is this one. Yes. And if we go in the message and the new message, we have hello XavKey. Okay, I think that's all for today. Well, yes, thank you for following this video. I say goodbye and see you in the next video. Bye.